Hi everyone, it's Rachel back with the Shades of Orange. Today I want to do a recent reads video focusing on some of the horror books I have been loving. And I have some great books to talk about, so let's jump right in. First, I want to talk about a book called Camp Slaughter by Sergio Gomez. I received a digital copy of this book for review from the author, and I really enjoyed this one. This is set over a couple different perspectives, and it primarily follows a group of college students that decide to go and party in the woods. However, the cabin that they have picked out is very secluded and happens to have a history of people going missing. We, as the reader, get to find out what is happening. People are not simply going missing, but are actually getting captured by cannibals in the woods. And I love a story with some cannibals because with that comes body horror. The story is also told from the perspective of paranormal investigators with a YouTube channel that are going around and trying to find out why these people are disappearing. So they get pulled into the story, and we also get the perspective of the cannibals themselves. And I love a story that gives you that villain perspective. I found this book incredibly creepy. And I don't say that about a lot of horror books, but the prologue alone I describe as nightmare fuel. I thought it was absolutely terrifying. The situation that they describe is possible, and I love realistic horror because it just feels that much more plausible that it could actually happen or happen to me. And the rest of the book definitely had some really scary moments. As I mentioned, this book definitely has elements of body horror, which I personally love. So you can expect that it's very gory, very gruesome. There's some very stomach-churning scenes. I don't want to describe too much because I kind of want you to experience the book for yourself. But as you can imagine with a cannibal story, there is definitely some gruesome aspects to it. So this book won't be for everyone, but I think there's a lot of other readers out there that, like me, like a horror book that can actually make me uncomfortable. And this one is disturbing and dark and all of my favorite horror buzzwords. So I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a lot of fun. It moves very quickly. I like the fact that it includes Hispanic characters. The author himself is of Mexican descent, and he does include his own culture in there. And it was just absolutely fun. It's so nice to talk about a book that is legitimately scary, at least to me. Everyone's scary threshold is going to be different. But if you're looking for a super scary book to check out and you're okay with some very gruesome, gory content, this is one I would definitely recommend. Next, I read a horror short story anthology called Tack to Me, and I received a digital copy through the publisher. This is a collection of stories that are all set in the Arctic North and are cold weather horror stories that are all written by Inuit authors. I was so excited when I found out about this because it checks so many of my boxes. I love to support Canadian authors, and I love stories that involve the North. I love that cold element brought into the horror genre, and this short story collection did not disappoint. I was very impressed by it. All the stories were very well written, as always is the case with anthologies. Some of the authors and their stories I connected with more than others, but for the most part, they were all very well written, very engaging. I will say that while they are horror stories, not very many of them were actually creepy or scary. Instead, I'd say the concepts surrounding the culture, the experience of being Inuit in the North were at the forefront of the stories, and a lot of times the horror elements of the story took a backseat, and there was just kind of lighter elements of suspense brought into the stories. However, there were some exceptions to that, but I did learn so much about the culture. It's not something that I knew a lot about beforehand, and I love the inclusion of language and experience and just the ideas of what it's like to live in a place where the sun does not set at times, or other times it's dark for most of the day. And I thought it was really engaging. There were two short stories that particularly stood out for me. One was about a blizzard, which would be so much fun to read during a snowstorm because it had such a good atmospheric feel to it. The other short story I loved because it had some body horror, because it was a first person story told from the perspective of a man who is a cannibal. Apparently, I'm really enjoying cannibal stories right now, but This one just worked so well for me. I thought it was legitimately creepy and probably one of the scariest short stories I have ever read. So I definitely recommend the short story anthology. If you get a chance to check it out for yourself, it's well worth it. And it's a great example of diverse horror, which I'm always looking to find, promote, and I really love this anthology, if you can't tell, so I do recommend it to other readers. Finally, I read a book called The Fisherman by John Langham, and this is a book I checked out from my library. I wanted to read it since I watched Thomas from SFF180 do a fantastic review where he described it and just got me really excited about it. He primarily does reviews of science fiction fantasy, but around Halloween he does 12 days of horror book reviews, which is so much fun, so I definitely recommend checking out so you can enjoy the videos during this fall season. However, this book follows a man who was widowed, and in order to move past his grief, he ends up taking up the activity of fishing. One of his co-workers also loses his wife as well as his children in a horrific car accident, so this man decides to invite him along to go fishing and hopefully move past his grief as well. The first part of this book is about these two men as they bond, and it's a very quiet, intimate story that is just a wonderful character story that definitely has some literary qualities to it. I'm happy to say that I'm coming to appreciate literary horror more than I ever have before, and this book was so well written, so enjoyable. The second part of this book is when the men decide to go and fish in a lake that they have never fished in before, but the owner of a diner that they stop in on the way warns them to stay away and gives them the history of this lake. And as well as you would expect in a horror book, they don't necessarily heed that advice, so they do go fishing, and the last part of this book is filled with cosmic horror as they find the consequences of what they got themselves into. So the reason I want to mention that this book is written in three parts is the fact that I got so pulled into that first section. I got immediately attached to both men. I think the author did a really good job of creating this quiet story with so much emotional depth to it. And I was just completely invested, which made the second part of this book very frustrating because it's very jarring. You get a huge shift in perspective and you're basically told over roughly 150 pages this huge history of this body of water. And while it makes sense why it's in there, it does build up to the third part of the book. It was just frustrating because I wanted to go back to the story of these two men. And it gave me the experience of when you're reading a really good book and then for some reason you have to put that book down and read a different book. It doesn't matter how good the second book is because I just wanted to get back to the story of the men, the story that I was already interested in. And it just felt like a bit too much of a story within a story, which is not one of my favorite things to read in books. However, even with that second part of the book, which was frustrating, I still love the book as a whole and would recommend it. If you're someone who enjoys more literary horror, it's not necessarily scary, but just very well done, very character focused, and a very intimate story of grief. This is an excellent one to pick up. I would recommend it. I very much liked it, and I just thought it was a wonderful story, and I would like to check out more by this author. So that's it for this really quick round of recent reads. Of the three books I mentioned, which one are you most interested in checking out for yourself? Also recommend to me your favorite cannibal books, because apparently I enjoy books about cannibals. Also recommend me some literary horror, because I'm also enjoying those books as well. As always, thank you so much for watching. I will talk to you again soon. Okay, bye-bye.